Hello everyone, welcome to my channel and today we have new guest who you know, he is Divansh Nehta and he is a co-founder of Just Be and he is the son of Nidhi Nehta and you might all have seen maybe, yeah right? And so can you tell about your journey, like from childhood to now, like what is your journey? Like people doesn't know, right? What
That's
is
true.
Your journey, like how you grown up? What is your education and what you are now?
Mm-hmm.
So that
so hi everyone, I'm Divansh Nehta and so as a kid my journey is very easily summarized by Robert Frost's words: two roads diverged into a woods and I took the road less traveled.
Mm.
And why I say that is because as a kid I was born with a visual challenge and the doctor said that you have to go for special schooling. He's a child who's a special child. But my mother's resilience and dedication brought me where I am today. So today, being a person with a double degree in finance and economics from Loyola Marymount University, today someone who's running the operations of Just Be, the front end of the house. And this is Just Be being India's whole food plant-based restaurant, first whole food plant-based restaurant. And the major driving factor is that I want to take my mother's legacy forward. And in so post which I have of course gained a lot of experience as an investment banker, content writer and as a resident advisor for my university. But I think that once I joined this noble cause of Just Be and what we are serving to people is good health. And because that belief of we are what we eat and a healthy body always has a healthy mind set with me very soon, and I after that there was no looking back. So in love with what I do, and this is just a little bit about me.
Yeah, so when you started your journey about like veganism or like whole food diet,
so my journey started in 2020. So
is there any purpose for that you turned this
yes definitely. So for me what happened was that it was around 6 years that I was away from home and I never sort of understood what plant-based or veganism was when my parents and my family turned vegan initially in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
So it took me a while to sort of get understand the concept, understand why people are doing it. That intrinsic shift didn't happen. And the moment I came back, I saw the kind of shift that my family has witnessed. And I, just from an angle of compassion, we lost our pet Zorro, who's a 4-year-old Great Dane who passed away due to multi-organ failure. And just all of these events in a sequence brought that empathy and that consciousness back in me that, hey, what I'm doing is not right. Or what I feel after I eat like a Domino's Maharaja Tandoori pizza with mint mayo to paneer and everything did not set well. I would feel horrible the next day. And I'm like, okay, fine, let's start making one conscious decision after the other. And at the end of the last conscious decision was joining Just Be by Nidhi Nehta. And since then, I have never looked back and I never sort of reminisce ki, okay, I want that kind of food or whatever. And I'm super proud and happy that our vegan community has made everything under the sun possible.
Yeah, that's a nice thing. And like when this restaurant started?
This restaurant started in 2017.
Mm-hmm. So you became that time a co-founder, right?
Yes.
You got an interest or your mother froze it?
Actually, since my childhood, she's been my... I have not had many friends. My mother's been my best friend.
Wow.
For me, she's been a pillar, a support system for anything. From as basic as, in the morning, is this outfit looking okay? To who should I marry? that entire spectrum of decision is first I will ask her and then make any decision. It's just that just got me hooked for first on ki, okay fine, despite me being in college, I would sort of handle in the night because there was a time difference. I would handle in the night social media, website development, so on so forth. I looked into with the people and in some way or the other, when I would come here, I would be a part of the restaurant operations, learn the trade, interact with people. And that is how I've met all of you lovely people and also got into the entire space. And since then, it's second nature. For me, I don't have to sort of understand or try to learn what is happening. Now I know. So, and that's what made it much more easier to come into Just Be as a business front.
Mm-hmm. So, So from the beginning, you saw the journey of Just Be, right? Mm-hmm. So how did you find difficulty? Like people are not aware of that. Like they still like McDonald's, all those things, right?
And difficulties, yeah. If, I tell you, is there is inward and outward difficulties, mm-hmm. that we've seen. So starting with difficulties that happened inside.
Mm-hmm.
Before our launch in 2017, in around 20, on June 3rd, our food and beverage, the service team quit. Just right before the launch. So then what do we do? The launch still has to happen. The ball needs to move.
Yeah.
So our Marwadi instincts is very innate with hospitality. So we picked up plates, we took orders, we cleared tables, and that, like, that is how we ensured that this launch was a success. And then chefs, consultants, even junior chefs rejected us saying ki nahi sir hamara haath kharab ho jayega. Or enterprise that serves food with no oil, ghee, butter, dairy, meat, or refined or synthetic ingredients is bound to fail. And the other front is that we are serving something that was never in demand. Mm. So we've seen people get up and walk out like, no, I don't want to eat this kind of food. What is this food you're serving? And we've seen that entire education process changing in terms of people being more aware. Now we have, touch wood, we have people who are requesting gluten-free options.
Mm.
And that is a beautiful transition that we've seen. And this is just the start of that entire wave that we are going to witness in the couple years.
Yeah, that's a nice thing. Like even I believe, like it's like we are like the chosen people. So we 100%. Have to change the society.
100%.
But for that, we need a lot of strength and that thing. But you have all the strength and you have the family also, right? Together,
yes,
you have done this. It's not possible like as a one person.
Never.
Yeah.
So I definitely agree with you. It's never possible by one person. And the goal of Just Be is not to have like 500 Just Be's across India. Our mission and vision is very simple, that we want to inspire other people ki even through COVID, our conscious effort was that we will not shut down, because that will be the biggest demotivator for any person who's looking to venture out into the conscious and compassionate space. That today we should be able to set a benchmark or be an example that Just Be is existing and it is thriving. And
yeah,
today with everyone's support, the vegan community, our wonderful patrons who keep coming regardless of what food preferences they have personally, and our team, today we are thriving. And recently we got crowned as India's best vegan restaurant.
Wow,
so by ZZest. So that was something which really attests to what we are building, and that is something that is going to be motivating other people to open hundreds of other conscious and compassionate enterprises, and eventually by the market will grow in itself.
Hmm.
We don't need to sort of then be like, nahi hum 5 Just Be khol diye, ab usko manage kar rahe hain, tab tak market people are not understanding. But
yeah,
it should be an inspiration, number one, always.
Yeah. Do you have a plan of opening branches?
We have, but we want other people to open first. That
mm-hmm.
we want to inspire people, and we want to make this a industry standard. That whole food plant based is an industry standard of the kind of food that needs to be eaten.
So you have come up with an idea of doing 50% off. You
yes.
have given that opportunity to people to come regularly.
Yeah.
They can have it. So what is that behind? Like, I feel like it's a loss for you, isn't it? Like, how you
no,
are managing?
It actually isn't a loss. Just
mm.
so for more clarity, it's not a loss. Definitely
mm.
not. But what the myth that we're trying to bust here is vegan food or eating healthy is not an elite man's food. Is
yeah.
what the myth that exists.
Yeah, people believe that. Yeah.
It is every person's food, and it needs to be for everyone to enjoy and consume. So, and by giving 50% off to people who have sort of been with us through the year and joined us during the new years, is just a way of our way of saying thank you to for supporting us, being with us through this entire year, through this entire 7-year journey. And we want you to, of course, keep coming more often and making Just Be a part of your life. And that is the major objective with which we offered this the community card to everyone.
Thank you so much. Thank you, it's ma'am. Actually it's a beautiful thing what you are doing is, and what you said is like we have to tell the people like it's not a like it's a not like a luxury thing, yeah, or costly thing. You can come and have a taste, and it's not a difficult thing also, like they can try at least
100%.
Even other people has not tried it, they can also, yeah, come and try it.
And we've seen people like such as yourselves, you brought so many people to give it a try that okay boss, try, yeah, food. This is what vegan food is, or this is what whole food plant-based food is, this is what health looks like. Aisa nahi hai ki aapko, I've put like five lettuces together with some vegetables and given you a salad. It is everything that you've always eaten, just in a different format.
Yeah.
And with the cleanest ingredients in the city. So that, uske liye aapko वो नहीं सोचना कि अरे ये खाली ये लोग खा सकते हैं, हम लोग नहीं, yeah, खा सकते. दैट थॉट शुड नॉट एग्जिस्ट. फूड इज फॉर एवरीवन, एंड नेचर हैज मेड इट सो अबंडेंट दैट इट इज रिन्यूएबल एंड फॉर एवरीवन, एंड दैट इज व्हाट वी मस्ट रिस्पेक्ट, एंड स्टॉप ईटिंग फूड दैट इज मेड इन अ फैक्ट्री और पैकेज्ड प्रोसेस्ड और इन एनी रिगार्ड व्हिच इज नॉट मेंट फॉर अस. सो वी राइट फूड हैज विल नेवर फेल.
And it's a good thing, like we people think like healthy means like they always imagine that it won't be tasty.
Yes.
But believe me, when you come here and taste the dish, any of the menu, you try it and then you say, instead of telling just imaginary, yeah, words. Yeah,
100%. And yeah, it's how there was this when I was younger, there used to be a chocolate ad that used to play, Melody Khao Khud Jaan Jao. So you have to come try it for yourself to know it.
Yeah, try it first, then you will get to know. And I wanted to know about, yes, your personal life, like, mm-hmm, are you married, like how
no many? I'm single.
Single?
Yes.
So are you sorry?
Not at all.
Okay, your elder brother is
my married. Elder brother is married, yes. He's married, been married for 3 years now.
3 years?
Yeah.
So he has a kid?
No, he has not. Planning.
Okay.
Yeah.
So are you planning? Are you dating anyone or someone can now?
No, ma'am. I'm open to everyone. But right, yeah, now, all focused on my career. That is, I want to definitely scale Just Be and bring it to a place where Just Be is a household name, where you think health. Think Just Be, always.
Yeah, but yeah, you are such a kind person. Anyone can fall in love with you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So it's a gift or a great opportunity for someone like who married you.
Thank you, ma'am.
So I that you mentioned that your brother is already married. Like,
yes.
How was like I'm curious. Like, how was his marriage function? Like, is that a vegan or this?
It was 100%. I can proudly say that it was 100%. And vegan wedding.
Wow.
And how we did it was, first he got married during COVID's second wave. April 26th was the lockdown that was supposed to happen. 24th he got married. We had a small group of 30 people that attended, and it was at the Leela Palace. Chef Zafar was very kind to comply, use our plant-based alternatives that we supplied him, and make an entire vegan menu in our for our event. And then we did a reception where we had around 350 people, actually more than that. And what we did was, we laid the buffet out. We never spoke a word to anybody. We didn't say anything that this food is vegan, this food is this, that. Everyone had the food. Then as a family, we stood right at the exit of the buffet, thanking everyone for contributing to their own health, stopping animal cruelty and making the world a better place, because the entire buffet or the entire meal that they've had was plant-based. And that sort of blew people's mind. Majorly why is because nobody imagined the food to be vegan. They're like, we thought this was this. And the reaction was phenomenal. And then people's interest be like, vegan khana ye hai.
Yeah.
They're like, hum jo soch rahe the wo vegan khana nahi hai.
Yeah.
So that entire myth got busted.
Yeah.
And that is what we wanted to drive home.
Yeah.
And start such a beautiful association in the most auspicious manner.
Yeah, that's a great thing hearing about that, and it's not an easy thing also, like doing this big event, and
we had a lot of backlash from the Marwadi our elders and community that we're not having this, that. We're like, we'll make everything possible, don't worry, but in the most conscious and the compassionate way.
So what do you want to say, like, people who says like only food taste is important, like if we can't try vegan food or plant-based food, what do you want to say in one message to them? Like,
so my message would be, stop thinking.
Yeah.
Is majorly why is that is because we have become a generation who first, or we have come to a time where we eat first with our eyes then with our nose, and then with our mouth. Food is meant to be first eaten with the mouth, and then all the other senses are meant to be activated through food. So food is our medicine, and it does not need to have any sort of extra drama done to it. Like you have your nitrogen gas, or it has your colorings added to it, or it shouldn't. It's, food is meant to be as simple as possible and meant to power you through your life and through your day. It's not ki I had lunch, I will take an afternoon nap. Now I had dinner, I will drink tea and I'll sleep. That is not what food is meant to do. And if we balance our meals, if we balance our sort of, if we just make a conscious effort to choose the right options, then our life is extended. Are we not experiencing what we just have called diabetes, cholesterol, hypertension, sugar? All of these things are not lifestyle diseases. These are human action induced diseases, and we'll avoid all these. So, and similarly with our philosophy at Just Be is very simple, that you need to go from hospitality to home, not the hospital. And that is what needs to be the entire chain of thought.
Nice thought, and nice belief system you have. And that we have to change our thoughts, actually. What we have like a thought, like something we have heard, like we have imagined, and just break it down and just try it. And
our conditioning needs to be broken. Yeah, definitely. 100%.
So I want to ask you one question, like if anyone wants to open their restaurant, vegan restaurant or plant-based restaurant, what do you want to suggest them? Like,
My thought is, number one is, running a restaurant in general is a lot of hard work. It's a lot of hard work, it's a lot of sleepless nights, it's a lot of being on the floor, getting your hands dirty, and making sure that each and every individual is served as though they are your own family, or they are your guests who are coming into your home. And if you're cut out for that hard work, then a vegan enterprise, first is practice what you preach, then majorly is be smart about your decisions. And this is the most right time to get into it, because there is a huge wave post COVID that people are looking to turn more conscious, more compassionate, and look for mindful options to what they put in their mouth. So my suggestion would be, start small, keep exponentially compounding your efforts, and eventually the direction in which you want to go will always be there. And be okay with failure, and be okay to pivot. So if you see Just Be, we've done hundreds of things, and we've failed at hundreds of things, we've passed at hundreds of things, and what we've passed at, or what we feel that yes, this is our core and this is what we've retained. We've done meal subscriptions, we've done different kind of events, talks, we've done we do caterings, we've done so many things. And what we've realized is that by process of trying, failing, struggling consistently, is that okay, fine, what we can do and what we should do. That answer will unfold for yourself based on who you are, what your skill sets are, and what you feel that you can best contribute to the entire community. This purpose is not just about you, me, or Sanath. It's about the entire vegan community across the globe. And this purpose is bigger than all of us. And that is what we need to focus on more than anything.
However, is that the right time to open the restaurant?
100%.
Okay. 100%. So how you feel, like, is it a competitor, or how it is?
As I was always mentioning, that it's never a competition. The one thing that we are really proud of is that there are people opening conscious and compassionate kitchens. That means that people are shifting what they're eating, and that is a huge positive sign. And from a very business angle, and to put it very crudely, the pie is not big enough for someone to compete with each other. Today we have to come together to build the pie first, and then we can even think of competing, because what a collaboration can yield, competition will never yield that. And the one thought that I would like to share in this regard is that if you want to walk fast, you walk alone, but if you want to walk far, you walk together. And that is what we want to go the distance with everyone together, rather than just be pushing ahead, or and as much support. And we're as good as friends with Vegan Vogue, Copper and Cloves, Natureville, Cafe Grace, and we've built that sense of community, that today if we are there, we celebrate each other, and we're there for each other through anything. And that is what a true community means, and that is what we are as a vegan community.
Wow, that's a nice thing you have. And which restaurant do you say that, like, after Just Be, it will be like,
so when I want to have ma'am, this is a very difficult question, and I don't want to take sides. All of them are fantastic. Please, when you're choosing health, choose conscious restaurants. When you're choosing guilt, choose like a little more vegan but unhealthy restaurants. So the choice is yours, but there are options are plenty. You can definitely take your pick of the select options that are available.
So what do you want to say to people, like why they have to choose Just Be?
So of course, think health, think Just Be. But if you've not come to Just Be, I invite you personally to come experience being at home while you're still outside and experience just food that will love you back. And what Just Be has to offer is that it is a home to everyone and anyone. There is no sort of set way of, no, I have to sit this way, eat this way, do this. You can just be you at Just Be. That's why the name Just Be You.
Nice thing. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
For
it was an absolute pleasure.
Thank you
for giving me your time. I thoroughly enjoyed this conversation with you.
Thank you so much. Pleasure, ma'am. Nice meeting to you.
Pleasure meeting you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.